I'm Sir Tap-Tap, and welcome to Let's Play Tembo, the Badass Elephant. If you copy this game, it's provided free of charge by Sega. So, this is Gamefreak's new game. Yes, it is, Parker. Bit of a surprise announcement a few months back, I think. Yes, hello, Parker. So, it's a 2D platformer of... slightly similar to Donkey Kong Country, I guess. We'll see why in a bit. What do you think about that, Parker? Parker is assisting here. So it's got this comic book style, and it's a bit like, we've got our G.I. Joe villains here, and so Tembo is our savior elephant dude here. Parker is sniffing my microphone. So, the game isn't super long. It's 15 bucks. Took me, according to my save file, about 6 hours to beat it. Of course, there's 100%, which would add a few more hours on there at least. The game's fairly hard. It's not a one-hit kill game, but it's not like Super Meat Boy style hard, but you'll die a few times. I actually rather like the tutorial here. I don't mind a good tutorial. My main problem with tutorials is when they stop you and pop up dialogues and stuff. Instead of just, you know, like, I like this where, you know, there's obstacles and signs when necessary to show you the controls. And you just sort of get used to it at your own pace. And ideally a way to skip it if you've played it before. This is a new save file. I have beaten a game, but this is showing off from the start. I like Tembo's moves. He's got a lot of stuff he can do here. He moves pretty well for an elephant. One interesting little thing here. I'm playing the PS4 version, by the way. Tembo actually has vibration just for normal walking, like... it's really subtle. Like, I'm impressed that the DualShock 4 can actually vibrate that little. Like, he just has little teeny bits for when he walks here. Like, you can barely feel it. And then a little bit more when he runs, and then you feel it a lot more when he lands. Especially when you do a slam. Oddly, it doesn't really rumble much when you thud into stuff. Oh, and one thing I like, all the comic book sound effects. Those are really neat. You can tell he's kind of paper doll animated there. It's pretty good job as far as paper doll animation goes, but still a little noticeable. I hope you can't hear Parker rubbing his face all over the microphone. It's kind of futile to try and keep him away. So yeah, we're Tembo and we're come to save the day. The game plays out over 4 worlds. The tutorial does not count as a world. I love his little salutes and stuff. So we're all about those peanuts. So yeah, there's nothing you really do at the base aside from... it's just basically the map screen. So yeah. The way everything works is that... there's a few normal levels, and then... the Phantom Dome level at the end of every world, and then there's a boss after that. And so you have to destroy a certain amount of Phantom property to unlock it. As long as you're fairly thorough, it's really not a big deal. I did have to go back once out of the entire game to go back and destroy more stuff. But you just have to be kind of thorough. It's a slightly collect-a-thon-y kind of thing. As you can see, we've got peanuts that are pretty much exactly like bananas in Donkey Kong Country. If you get 300 of them, you get a 1-up. And the sound effect even sounds like getting bananas. The game seems to sort of take cues from a bunch of different 2D platformers of that era. Like, there are certain challenge rooms that remind me of Kirby. The collect-a-thon-iness is sort of... it's more collect-a-thon-y than Donkey Kong Country is, really. Because there's... well, for one thing, there's these human survivors, or whatever you want to call them. There's 10 of them each stage, and you want to collect them all. It's not really necessary, but for 100% completion or whatever, you'd want to do that. And it also adds more, you know, destruction points, whatever you want to call that, that allows you to unlock... Oh, crap. The Phantom Dome at the end of the world. And there's lots of little secrets. Actually, I'm not sure if this... Yeah, this is a secret. That'll usually end up to a survivor here. And those big giant peanuts don't give you a one-up, they give you a third of a one-up, you know, 100 peanuts. So to get 100% completion, you want to defeat every enemy, and you want to go and destroy all the phantom property, which is usually, you know, big purple things. Phantom likes purple for some reason. And you gotta save all the survivors too, they count for 10 each, so that's 100 destruction points right there for getting all of them. Parker, I can't see. The game is 2.5D, obviously, and it uses it decently well. I'm still rather... It's not exactly my favorite. I love when they do that. The little... I really love the comic sound effects stuff. I lost my train of thought. Oh yeah, there's destructibility too. The 2.5D. It makes decent use of the 2.5D because there's some... there's some stuff like that where, you know, zooms out, or sometimes you shoot onto a different plane, or, you can affect background objects like we just did, knocking down that structure there. And sometimes you want to not destroy physics objects, like here, actually, so you can get, certain optional stuff. It reminds me of Yoshi's Island a lot in that you've got a... You know, if you mess up certain stuff, you either have to die and redo a checkpoint, or, you know, redo the level. So you gotta be kinda careful. Whoa! Speaking of careful... Oh, we can also shoot water out of our nose thingy here. Trunk, that's what it's called. Yes. I know words. Being an elephant, Tembo has a little bit of... Like, certain actions take a moment of recovery, so you have to move fairly deliberately. Like, you control differently when you're spinning, and you'd hurt enemies when you're spinning. Otherwise, certain enemies won't take damage if you just jump on them normally. Humans will, but like tanks and stuff, you have to do a spin. So movement is a bit deliberate. It's not super, like, tanky and fussy like you might expect from... Aw, I missed a single enemy. But yeah, it's not super tanky or anything like you might expect out of an elephant. But there is a little bit of... You have to move deliberately. So there's leaderboards and stuff. They're not very impressive right now because I'm playing before release and there's like... You know, not as many people. I was actually on the top of several leaderboards. Probably because I just happened to be lucky and there's not many people out there yet. Yeah, it does feel good to try and, you know, do a pretty good, you know, high-speed run and get all your points. It's not by score, it's by score and not by time, rather. The scoring system, or the leaderboard system. I'm not 100% sure how it all works out, because I haven't really gone for high scores, but it adds a layer of replayability onto it. If you're not going for high score and not going for 100%, there's not too much post-game content or anything. You know, you just, it's a platform, you beat all the levels, and you go for 100% if you want to. Basically every level adds a new gimmick. I don't mean that in a negative way, but like say Super Mario 3D World, that game was like entirely good because each level was pretty much its own new gimmick. And it would not have been as good, in my opinion, if, you know, it wasn't like that. This game usually has one major and one minor gimmick per world. Like, every world has a major gimmick. Like, in World 2, it's these plants that you can water. And this one, it's more like fire and stuff. And then each level has its own, you know, style and gimmick. Like this one, we're on our train here, and we've got these explodey block things. And there's some more puzzles, mostly later on there's puzzles, I'm not sure we'll see any of the puzzles. They're not really huge brain twisters or anything. But, they keep it fresh in some of the later levels by mixing up how you progress through stuff. Like, there's one area where it's like, I thought it was gonna do a boss rush or something on me. You get four doors out. And you can choose which one to go through, and you just have to go through each door. So a little non-linearity there. Ow. The tanks always give me trouble because you can't... Ah. I always want to, like, bum-rush them and stuff, but why aren't you attacking? There we go. But if you do that, you can end up taking, like, one or two hits, and that's a fair bit of your health. So I'm going to try to be a little careful here. And thanks to the 2.5D, you can see little optional areas like that. Those, you'll be finding those fairly often. And generally the secrets are fairly easy to find. Like in Donkey Kong Country Tropical Freeze, I found the hidden stuff kind of a bit too well hidden in some cases. Like I went with the frickin' with Squawks, you know, who shows you where the stuff is, and I still didn't find some of the stuff. And I didn't really have the patience for all of that. If you're paying attention, oh crap, which I obviously am, if you're paying attention, you can find pretty much all of this. So this is what happens when you die. You just eat a jar of peanut butter and you're perfectly fine. There's a fair number of checkpoints in each level, so you shouldn't lose too much progress. The game can be a little frustrating on your first time through certain levels. Like, you might probably die several times to certain areas. Like, there's some areas where you just, if you make one moderate mistake, you're pretty much dead, and you'll have to redo that section. But, like, there's certain areas where, like, a death wall will be chasing you. Parker. Parker, get down. Can't see. Parker. If you want added difficulty, get a cat. They're very helpful in that sense. Parker, seriously, get down. Alright. Now I've lost my train of thought. It's not an easy game, but not super difficult either. It's not like trying to be Super Meat Boy. Parker, come on. Okay, so, and your destruction count or whatever that's called is basically like how far you are through the level as long as you, bye-bye. Wait, do I not get credited for that kill? That's rude. So you can sort of tell how far you are through the level. Aw, crap, I think I missed something. There are certain times where I'm not entirely sure where to go. Here's a sort of not quite mini-boss deal. So these guys are a little confusing at first. If you bump into them, it kind of looks like they might be taking damage, but no. They have to flash red for them to be taking damage. So you just gotta wait for them to jump over you and hit them in the butt. A giant glowing meat point. Though, and most of the vehicles will pop out the soldier that was piloting them when they explode, so you have to go kill the guy too. Whee! Oh, you have to press the button. Bye bye. So that's pretty much the ropes. We'll take a peek here at the next level. This level uses a lot more use of the shooting water, which we haven't seen very much of yet. Oh, I will make one note. The performance, occasionally you'll get some frame drops in certain areas. It's not super common, but I'm not sure how it performs on PC or Xbox One, but it hasn't, like, gotten me killed or anything. It's not common or anything, but It's a little frustrating when it does happen. Just little drops here and there. Parker. He's just sitting there right in front of the screen. Get down, honey. Come on. Oh, these. So yeah, there's quite a few gimmicks we haven't seen yet. But these things are very Donkey Kong Country-ish. And just, you know, you shoot, bah. You can change the direction. You probably shouldn't, because it just confuses me. And usually when you see one of those, there'll be a way to, you know, find a secret. I just found the hiccup secret. So there we go. And all the destructible objects are highlighted by, like, flashing, stuff like that. And we get to play with bowling balls sometimes. They'll help you destroy stuff and solve puzzles on occasion. They're an instant kill on anything they hit. Parker, seriously. Get down. They can get kind of in the way, but... Damn it. There we go. I hate that tank. I always take damage to taking out that tank. You can generally instantly defeat things by taking out the ground under them. Oh, oh, oh. Oh, it's not a secret. I'll take that, thank you. Yeah, this is Tembo the Badass Elephant. Oh, right, we have a dash, like, slide. I guess the tutorial showed you that. We don't use it very much. But one other thing is that hopefully we'll be showing you the fire here stuff soon. Oh, there we are. So water erases fire, as you might expect. And... you can aim your trunk, and you can also, like, add a spout of water while you're dashing, which is very useful. I didn't realize this at first, and there were some areas where I would, like, have to spray and then walk, and then I found out you can just spray water as you're dashing. And you have a limited amount of water, that's your blue meter there. So yeah, this level's gimmick is that you're in this big burning building, and you gotta take out the fires. Ow. And anytime, you know, there's fire puzzles, you'll have water to help you out. Oh crap, oh crap, oh crap. Poor Tembo. One complaint, it does take a little bit to get back started. I don't entirely mind the respawn animation, but there's a fair bit of loading on top of that. And like, you're not dying as often as Meat Boy, so it's not a huge problem, but you still do die a fair amount of times. I've even gotten a few game overs here and there. The game loves doing that, like shooting you through a bunch of glass windows, and it almost always frame drops when it does that. Kind of funny. Aw, come on, I was using water. Oh, also, if you're spinning and you shoot water, you do, like, you spray it all around. Come on. Those blue skulls are pretty annoying. They'll, they reignite after a moment. I just kind of rushed through this level. I didn't quite mean to show off the whole thing, but, since we're already this far. Oh, come on, I was still... Alright, let's try to be careful here. Oh, for Pete's sake. I think we've seen the gist of things. So that's Tembo the Badass Elephant. It is on PlayStation 4, Xbox One, PC. I think July 21st, probably when this video is live. $15. Pretty fun, a little bit towards the frustrating side sometimes, but I had fun.